Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. We're going to be continuing the series of six devlog videos that I'm doing on the six collectible event vehicles available in this year's summer event for War Thunder Operation H.E.A.T. So we took a look at the previous video was the BF-110C6, which is the first tier reward for aviation. In the event. Now we're taking a look at the top tier reward for the aviation section of the event, which is on the P-59A Airacomet. Now this is a very unique aircraft, and it's one that I have a little bit of interesting stuff, or is a little bit more interesting to me than the BF-110. Even though I love the BF-110, this is one that, well, as you'll find out in just a second, if you want to know how to get this vehicle, you have to, I believe, get... Yeah, okay, I had to actually go and check the thing just as a reminder. You need to get 11 aviation marks of distinction to unlock this aircraft. So it's going to take a little bit of extra grinding than the BF-110 took, but it's probably worth it because it's a very interesting aircraft. Now, this is, of course, the P-59A Airacomet, which is a jet-powered fighter aircraft for the United States of America, and it is of the fourth rank. Now, let's get a look at the pros and cons here. So the pros are that it has an excellent armament, as you'll see, and it is the first rank 4 jet-powered aircraft in War Thunder. So it's got a little bit of history to it, I guess. It's, well, obviously not going to be that fast, because as it says as a con, it is relatively slow in comparison to other jet-powered fighters. Now, why is this thing interesting to me? Even though it's not one of the ones I'm uber excited for, compared to some of the other event vehicles in this event, this is an aircraft that was on my original wishlist video. If you guys remember when I used to do the wishlist videos, this was one of the American vehicles for aviation that I really, really wanted because it looked really unique and it just sounded neat, and I thought it'd be a nice addition to the series of United States fighters. And now, well, it's coming to the game as a collectible in some variant. Now, here is some history on the aircraft if that's something that you're interested in. Now, just like it says that there will be collectible camouflages for every sixth of vehicle, like for all six of the vehicles there is going to be a collectible camouflage you can get that you get right after completing the enough marks of distinction to get the vehicle itself. So like for example on the BF-110, getting 5 marks of distinction will unlock you the aircraft, and getting 6 marks of distinction will unlock you the collectible camouflage for it, I believe. Same goes for the aircraft. Unfortunately, it doesn't actually show any other camouflage on the BF-110's devlog. It only shows whatever the paint it is carrying, whether that's the base paint or the collectible paint. Here it shows two different paint schemes on the PF-59. We've got what I assume to be the standard paint, which is of course the olive drab crap looking stuff. Not a bad looking aircraft either, I must say. I really like how simplistic and plain it looks on the top. It's very straight, very flat, very edgy, if you know what I mean. But then they also have an ass shot, which is, of course, the chrome unpainted look, which I really love, but again, not all that unique in terms of paint schemes to go for on the P-59, but it is what it is for right now because the other vehicles do have unique-looking paint, so I'll let this one slide. In War Thunder, however, the P-59A Airacomet is destined for greatness. This aircraft will serve as the Summer Marathon's main prize for War Thunder pilots. Not only will it be the first U.S. fighter jet, but also the first rank 4 aircraft of its kind. Now, I don't know what it means by U.S. fighter jet, because we have plenty of U.S. fighter jets. I think it just means it'll be the first U.S. fighter jet. I don't know. Like, the lowest tier one, so it'll be the first one you can get on their tech tree, as well as being the lowest tier 1 in the entire game. Although, of course, not everybody's going to be taking part in the event, you know. yes, it may be inferior to every other jet-powered fighter speed-wise, but it can, without a doubt, compete with all the top piston engine aircraft. The Airacomet's relatively modest speed makes it easier to control when performing maneuvers when compared to other fighter jets. The aircraft is also fitted with 2 engines, which certainly adds to survivability. Moreover, the P-59 is doing particularly well in the armament department. The front of the nose is fitted with a 37mm M4 cannon loaded with 44 rounds, as well as 3 rapid-firing high-caliber machine guns with a total ammo capacity of 1800 rounds. It looks nice. I like it. So there's a side shot of it. It's so narrow looking too. There's another ass shot. It's got like 2 boobs on the ass. There's a front shot. The front shot looks great. Gorgeous. And then of course there's another. That right there. Oh, that is such a nice looking shot. I love it. Holy crap. With that chrome look on it. Oh, it looks so nice. I think any plane would just benefit from that. So, what's the verdict then? The Airacomet is an excellent rank 4 aircraft with a speed of over 650 kilometers an hour, excellent frontal armament, and great handling characteristics. To get this aircraft, players must complete the War Thunder Operation Heat tasks for pilots. This unique aircraft with a unique story certainly deserves a place in your hangar. Now, again, just like with the BF-110, they don't specify if it is premium or not. I'm going to imagine that it is. I'm going to imagine all of the vehicles in this event are premium, because none of them go over rank. None of them match the top rank of that nation. So that's just an assumption. Don't take my word for it. We'll just have to wait and see. But that's just what I'm assuming. Either way, that's the P-59A. If you are excited for the P-59A, and if it's the one that you are most excited for, feel free to let me know in the comment section below. And if you are going to be taking part in the event in any which way, good luck to you on getting your rewards. Something smells like vomit.